Today, we're going to build a fully interactive dashboard in Microsoft Excel. In the past, that meant rolling up your sleeves with tables, pivot tables, charts, timelines, and slicers. Definitely not beginner friendly. But now, thanks to the brand new agent mode, or what I like to call Excel's AI beast mode, you can simply describe the dashboard that you want and Excel will build it for you. Now, as a quick note, you'll need a Microsoft 365 subscription and a Copilot license to follow along. I'm Kevin, and let's dive in. I've got all of this cookie sales data sitting in Excel on the web, which you could get to by navigating to excel.new. My manager wants me to make sense of it, ideally with a dashboard. Now, the problem, this wall of numbers doesn't really tell a story, unless you're looking for a bedtime story. So let's turn it into an interactive dashboard. Before we dive in, I'd like to quickly turn my data into a table. Now, this is not required, but it makes everything easier to work with. Filtering, sorting, and formatting all snap into place. To turn this into a table, go up to the top tabs up on top and click on Insert, and here we see the option for a table. I'll click on this, and my table has headers right up here, so I'll make sure to check this, and then let's click on OK. Next, we need to enable something called Agent Mode. To do that, let's go up to the top tabs and click on Home. Then, all the way over on the right-hand side, you'll see an option for add-ins. Let's click on that, and right up on top, we can search for an add-in. Let's type in Agent Mode, and right here at the top of the search results, you'll see something called Excel Labs, a Microsoft Garage project. Let's click on Add, and that adds a new icon to the ribbon, and right here it opens up a pane titled Excel Labs. Now, there are a few different options within Excel Labs, but we're going to use Agent Mode in Frontier. Let's click on Open. This is where the magic happens. Instead of manually crunching through all of this cookie sales data, we could simply describe the dashboard that we want. So right in here, I can type in my prompt. I'll type this in, and let's have a quick look. Build a dashboard to help me understand this data. Include some visuals. Include things like total revenue by cookie type, units sold over time, and profit by month. Add other tables or charts that are relevant and will help tell the story behind this data. Now, Agent Mode will generate the initial dashboard based on this prompt, but the best part is you can keep refining it. If you want different charts, new calculations, or maybe extra visuals, all you have to do is ask. The agent will just update it for you. Now that I've entered in my prompt, let's see what Agent Mode comes up with. Right down here, let's click on this button. Once you hit enter, Agent Mode starts planning out the steps it needs to build the dashboard. It doesn't just jump straight to the result. It actually reasons through the task, figuring out how to pull the data, which charts to create, and how to structure the dashboard. Think of it like having an Excel power user sitting right next to you, sketching out the plan before doing any of the work. And here's what Agent Mode came back with, a complete interactive dashboard. Now, over here on the right-hand side, you can actually see the steps that Agent Mode took to build this dashboard. So here it walks through what it built. Let's scroll down a little bit more. Where is everything on the dashboard? We could take a look at that. All the different formulas that it used in this dashboard, and also an explanation of how these different formulas and functions work. Let's scroll down a little bit more. Now, as I go down here, you could also see that it applied various verification steps just to make sure that all the different numbers are accurate. Now, I went back and I confirmed that these numbers are in fact true. Here, if we look down a little bit more, we also get quick insights based on the data. Here it says chocolate chip leads revenue by a wide margin. Well, looking at this chart, it sure does seem like chocolate chips are very popular. It also tells me about the different formatting choices it made. And if we scroll down even more, here it gives me some ideas of additional items that I can add to my dashboard. That is so cool. And here it says, if I want any changes, just say the word. I will do that. Over on the left-hand side, let's now take a look at the dashboard itself. Right at the top, I have a KPI summary, and it shows me information like the total revenue, total profit, total units, and also the average profit margin. Now, one thing you'll notice is there's a lot of money in the cookie business. That's at least what mom always told me. If we look down below, here we see a breakout by product. So here I could see the different product types, the total revenue. Here I could see units sold by month as well as profit. And I also have associated visuals that go with all these different tables. One really important thing to call out here is that this dashboard is not just static. Under the hood, it's all built with real Excel tables, formulas, and charts. That means it's refreshable. So if my data changes, or maybe I add new data, the entire dashboard updates automatically. Let's now try changing some of the data to see how everything updates in our dashboard. So take a look at this total revenue number. It's 4.69 million. I'll go back to the original data. And let's say that this chocolate chip order was actually for a lot more revenue. Let's say that it was actually a $1 million order. So there, I'll update that number, and here we see 1 million. Now, if I go back to the dashboard, look at this. The total revenue automatically updates to reflect that change in the original data. Now, at the beginning of this video, I said I would make this interactive. Let's see if we could add a slicer that lets me filter the dashboard by cookie type. So back over on the right-hand side where we have the prompt box, I'll type in add a slicer that lets me filter the dashboard by cookie type. Then let's submit that. And look at that, it added a slicer directly onto my worksheet. Now, I should be able to filter the entire dashboard with just a single click. So let's try looking at all of this data on this sheet just for chocolate chip. I'll click on this, and did you see that? It updated all of the tables and all of the charts just for chocolate chip. So let's try another cookie type. Let's go with white chocolate macadamia nut. I'll click on that, and here too, it updates all of the different charts and all the tables for that cookie type. Now here's a cool thing. I could press the control key on my keyboard and I could select multiple cookies to look at in this filter. Look at that. Now it's just showing me those four cookies that I selected. And remember, to set this up, all I had to do was ask. Agent mode handled all of the setup for me automatically. Now that we've got our dashboard, you probably want to clean it up before you share it with others. Now, of course, you could go through and you could move different items around, you could format it, or you could even work with the agent to get it to look how you want it. Here are a few quick things that you could do to make it look less like a spreadsheet and more like a dashboard or report. Up on top, let's click on the View tab, and here we could turn off headings. Now check that. We could also turn off the grid lines, and we could also turn off the formula bar. Okay, that's looking more presentable. Then down below, we have these two different sheets. We have sheet one, which contains all of the original data, and then the dashboard. I could right click on this sheet, and here we could hide that. That way, people will only see the dashboard, not the underlying data. Once you're ready to share out your dashboard with others, in the top right-hand corner, you could click on the share icon, and here you could share it, or you could copy a link and then send that to others. That's pretty incredible. As long as you can describe what you want, you can now create it in Excel. Now, it's available on the web and coming soon to desktop. Now, here's a crazy thought. Maybe you don't even need the ribbon anymore. Maybe all you need is a prompt box. Now, you might be wondering, how is agent mode different from Copilot? Copilot is great for quick, one-off tasks, like let's say generating a formula, a chart, or maybe just a quick summary. Agent mode, on the other hand, takes it even further. It's like an AI assistant that plans and builds with you. You could give it a complex request, like build a dashboard like we did in this video, and it figures out the steps, creates the pieces, and even checks its own work. If you've ever wanted to build a dashboard, but maybe found it a little bit overwhelming, well, now is pretty much the easiest time to get started. And who knows, maybe agent mode will become your new best friend. Please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.